still thinking about that last match, but we got to move on and move into the last round of this daily. Our hand is pretty strong here. So here's where I would actually almost consider getting a red-white land off the Scalding Tarn, because we only have an island here, and we have both red. We have a couple red cards here, but we might need to cast also a Path to Exile that we might draw. So Sacred Foundry might not be the worst land to fetch. What are you playing, Tenjim? Jund? It's generally what Marsh Flats, but yeah, it looks like Jund. So it's a Deathrite Shaman. So yeah, I'm going to get just a red-white land here. And just bolt it right away so I can cast a Think Twice next turn. Hope he doesn't play a Goyf. If he plays a Dark Confidant, I'm okay with that. We can Electrolyze it. Goyf would be pretty bad. Like I said, this is the matchup where I feel it's like 50-50. Oh, no, okay. Okay, this matchup's actually a lot better than 50-50. Looks like he's just playing Malir. Oh. Oh, maybe it's like a green-black-white junk deck? I don't know. Anyways, we can't actually counter it, so we just think twice, and next turn we will Electrolyze. Yeah, I like Electrolyze over the Pyroclasm here. He might have Lingering Souls and stuff, and I also need to draw lands. I know we're taking 2 damage here, but in the controller, you don't want to be missing land drops. And I think this also is telling about his hand. Like playing this on turn 2 probably means that you're kind of light on lands, because you generally wait to play the Gavinny Township. All right. Do not care about Thoughtseize. What does he take here? Snapcaster Mage? Electrolyze? Sphinx Scissor? Oh, sure. Ooh, that was nice. Oh, so it looks like he's playing Raptor's deck. Alright, so let's cast a Think Twice here and try to draw a Spell Snare. Come on! No such luck. So we're going to take a lot of damage off this Goyf. Like, I could Snapcaster Mage targeting Lightning Bolt. The only problem with that is if he has a removal spell for the Snapcaster Mage, I don't actually get to kill Tarmogoyf. Our hand is good at killing little things. A Tarmogoyf, not so much. Yeah, I think I'm just going to take it. Alright, so let me think twice first before make any decisions. Because if we do draw land, we can actually Snapcaster Mage, Lightning Bolt, Electrolyze the Tarmogoyf. So we're going to be looking to find a land here. And yeah, we've taken some damage off of our lands. I might actually want to just fetch a Plains off the Arid Mesa. I'm surprised he still can't cast anything. His hand must be like 2 Lilianas and a Garrick or something. And if we do draw a Path to Exile, we're going to wait, obviously, till his turn. I mean, the only downside of getting the Plains here is that, if we draw a Cryptic Command, we can't cast it. But that might... Saving the 2 damage might be more important here. No, this is not... Sorry, guys. This is not exactly Raptor's deck. This is a green-black-white deck. He's playing Gavinny Township. On the bright side, it's likely that he doesn't have red in his deck, so there's a little less reach with the Lightning Bolts and such. But Gavinny Township, so he probably has lingering souls. So on the following turn, you know, if we do draw our sixth land, my plan is going to be if he when he attacks with Tarmogoyf, I'm gonna cast a Snapcaster Mage targeting the Lightning Bolt, and then if he doesn't choose to kill it, I can actually just block and bolt it and save the electrolyzes. Our opponent's thinking very hard about this. Okay. All right, well, we drew an island, so now we can just get our planes. Flashback to think twice. Don't really want to be taking more damage necessarily, so I'm going to just play the island here and pass. All right, Snapcaster Mage, targeting the Lightning Bolt. What could he have here? A Garrick? I don't know. Liliana, okay. So let us... He's so close to dead, but yeah, I think we still have to kill Tarmogoyf. All right, so I'm gonna just pitch a Tarn here. Yeah, all right. And let's electrolyze the Liliana. Draw a card. And electrolyze it again. I guess I can Snapcaster Electrolyze, but I kind of want to Snapcaster Revelation if at all possible. So, yeah. All right. Play this and pass. Yeah, I want to be able to like Snapcaster Revelation for 3. Snutter Liliana? Yeah, okay. Oh, well, there goes all of our basics. I think I'm just going to discard the Arid Mesa here. Well, he just had a bunch of removal spells in his hand, I guess. Thoughtseize. Alright, well, now jigs up. He's going to get the best card out of our hand here, but I think we still do it. Hopefully, it's just all gas. Cooking with gasoline. That is not cooking with gasoline. It is, in fact, the opposite. Oh, that, however, is sweet. All right. Attack Liliana. What do we want to do here? I mean, I'm definitely playing the Colonnade. The question is, do I, like, Snapcaster Bolt the Liliana? Do we even care about the Liliana? No, I think I might just want to burn him out. Yeah. I'll just get rid of this Pyroclasm. He drew all 4 Lilianas, I guess. Yeah, so he's dead. So he's going to attack us here for 3. We're going to Snapcaster Bolt him down to 6th and attack with Colonnade. All right. So we got him. So green, black, white with path to exile, some removals. Sure. Okay. So in this particular matchup, let's see. Pyroclasm is good. Dispel is not. I don't think Tectonic Edge is... We really want the Tectonic Edge here. Nor do we want Wear and Tear. Threads of Disloyalty is also very good. Celestial Purge, maybe Wrath of God. Don't want the Counter Fluxes. Maybe the Explosives. All right. Well, I'm just putting in the maybes here, and then we'll figure out. So Shadow of Doubt is pretty bad. I like the Spell Snares. Mana Leaks are also not bad because it counters the Lilianas. Spellskite is probably not great. Wrath, I mean, they are a little bit slow, but the fact that you can kill Tarmogoyfs and some number of Lingering Souls tokens means that we should probably play them. All right, Crucible is probably loose. I like the Spell Snares because he does have Dark Confidants and Tarmogoyfs, and he could potentially have Voice of Resurgence. I'm not sure. He's playing a green-white deck, so it's one of our few ways to actually, you know, deal with the Tarmogoyf. Maybe like two Cryptics. Maybe we just want one Hallowed Burial. It's a little expensive. Explosives is a little bit slow, but it does kill the Goyfs for two mana and also kills Liliana. So I think I want to just bring it in as like a slow answer to those things. Maybe cut one Think Twice. Well, Think Twice is pretty good against Liliana, but we might not have time to be casting a lot of Think Twices. And maybe we just cut like one Mana Leak. Alright, so this sideboarding was a little bit loose. I'll have to talk over with some other people to see exactly how they sideboard in this particular matchup.